TLS inspection with the AWS Network Firewall can help keep your payloads secure and give you the inspection capability you need. But your TLS inspection won't work if you miss one of these three requirements. Hi, I'm Brandon Carroll, and here's how you can avoid hours of troubleshooting. Let's go. Number one, certificate authority requirements. The first and most important step is ensuring you have a valid CA certificate and that it's configured properly. If you have a look at the documentation, the CA certificate you import into AWS Certificate Manager or ACM must have the X509 V3 basic constraint extension set to CA true. What this indicates is that the certificate can be used to sign other certificates, which is a critical requirement for the TLS inspection use case. You can verify this using OpenSSL with the command OpenSSL X509-N, the cert-text-noout. You want to look for the X509 V3 basic constraints field, and it should say CA true, like you see here. If the certificate doesn't have this set correctly, ACM will reject the import with an error like this. So, how can you resolve this issue? Well, you need to generate a new CA certificate with the proper basic constraints extension configured. There are plenty of online guides and examples for doing this with OpenSSL. Okay, let's talk about number two, server certificate requirements. In addition to the CA certificate, you'll also need to provision server certificates for the domains that you want the firewall to inspect. The server certs should be signed by the CA certificate you imported into ACM. When you configure the TLS inspection settings in the firewall, you'll associate these server certificates with the appropriate domains. The firewall will then use these certificates to decrypt and re-encrypt the TLS traffic flowing through the firewall. Again, it's super important that the server certificates are properly signed by a valid CA cert. If the server cert isn't signed by the CA you've configured, the TLS handshake is going to fail and the traffic won't be inspected. And finally, number three, trusted root store configuration. The final piece of the puzzle is making sure the CA certificate is trusted on the client devices accessing the protected resources. Since the firewall is acting as a man in the middle, it's generating its own server certificates on the fly that are signed by the CA you've provided. For the client to trust these dynamically generated certs, the CA cert needs to be installed in the client's trusted root store. This is another step that is often overlooked. If the CA cert isn't trusted, the client will reject the TLS connection. Now, you can deploy the CA cert on the client devices in a number of ways, such as through enterprise certificate management tools, OS level settings, or browser extensions. The key is to make sure all your client devices that'll be accessing protected resources have the right trusted root certificate installed. In summary, the three main pitfalls to watch out for with TLS inspection certificates are: one, ensuring the CA certificate has the proper basic constraints extension set to CA true; two, provisioning server certificates that are signed by the configured CA; and three, distributing the CA certificate to client devices so the dynamically generated server certs are trusted. By following these guidelines, you'll have a smooth rollout of TLS inspection and avoid any certificate-related issues. If you have questions, let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more technical tips just like this one.